Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can implement integer class to add, subtract, multiply and divide two integers in C++. If you want to learn programming, you can connect with me by following these details. You can also download my app Tachymeth that is available on Google Play. You can search my channel on YouTube by typing my name Sanjay Gupta. My channel will be available there. It contains various programming related videos and playlists. You can subscribe my channel by clicking on this button. Now coming on to the topic, I am going to implement integer class to add, subtract, multiply and divide two integers in C++. So first of all, I am going to include a header file iostream, then I am using a namespace std. This namespace is predefined in iostream header file. It is used for cin and cout. Now class integer, inside this class I am declaring a variable int n. Then in public section I am defining first function, that is read. Here message will be enter a number, it will be displayed on console. Then a number will be received using cn inside n variable. For line termination I am using endl. Endl stands for end line. Then second function, that is print, it will display value of n on console. So these are two functions for reading and printing value of n. Now I will be implementing four functions for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So I am using name of class as return type, then function name, then integer I. This I is formal argument. Here inside definition I am creating a temporary object t, then I am adding values of attribute n. After addition I am returning the object t. So this is first function for addition. This function name is sum. It will return an integer type object and it is receiving an argument of integer type inside I. Then t object, which is temporary object, is created. Here this n is representing implicit arguments value and I dot n is representing explicit arguments value. Both are added and assigned into temporary object's attribute, that is t dot n. After addition I have returned value of t, so it will be received inside main method while I will be calling sum function. So similar to this definition, I have to define three more functions, so I am pasting it three times. So you can see sum function definition is available four times. So now this is subtraction, then multiplication and then division. So starting from the beginning, you can see first function is read, second function is print, third function is sum, fourth is subtraction, fifth is multiplication and sixth is division. After implementing these functions, I am terminating the class. Now I am implementing main method. Inside main method I am creating three objects, i1, i2 and i3. Now I am printing a message, enter first value, then I am calling i1.read. Then enter second value and I am calling i2.read. So two values are received using these function call read function. Now I am calling i3 equals to i1 dot sum, and inside this I am passing an argument i2. Here i1 is implicit argument and i2 is explicit argument. The result of this addition will be stored inside i3, so I am calling i3 dot print, and before that I am printing a message sum is. And then return 0. So first I am showing you how sum will be called here, and the values of sum of two values will be displayed on console. So I am executing this code. You can see enter first value and enter a number. These messages are available here. So I am entering 10. Then enter second value, number, I am entering 20. And sum is, value of n is 30. So it is printing 30 as addition of 10 and 20. Now I am going to apply all other functions, that are subtraction, multiplication and division. So I am copying these statements and I have pasted them 3 times. So this first segment is for addition, then this is for subtraction, then multiplication, and then division. So this way I have called all 4 functions. This is calling of sum, this is calling of subtraction, this is calling of multiplication, and this is calling of division. Now 2 values you have to enter, and then addition, subtraction, multiplication and division will be called on those 2 numbers. You can also implement this using switch and case if you want to perform any specific operation. So right now I want to perform all the operations. That's why I have called all the functions in main function without using switch and case. So I am executing this code now. I am entering first number as 20 and second number as 30. You can see the output. Sum is, value of n is 30. Subtraction is, value of n is 10. Multiplication is, value of n is 200. 200. And then division is, value of n equals to 2. So this way all the functions are called and the results are displayed on console. So I hope you have understood how you can implement integer class to add, subtract, multiply and divide 2 integers in C++. In these functions I have passed objects as an argument and I have returned object as argument. So if you want more programming related videos, you can visit my channel on YouTube. Here various programming related videos and playlists are available. You can also subscribe it by clicking on this red button. Thank you for watching this video.